Hey guys, welcome to another review. I'm Mr. P, and today I'm going to be doing a review of a 22mm RDA from Keith and the lovely Kirsty over at vapegear.co.uk. So what I'm doing today is the Igo W6, and it's I don't know if I've annoyed Keith and Kirsty again, but it's a quad coil. It's a quad and dual called Igo W. This is a revised version from the versions that I've seen previous to this because the positive system works a little bit differently. So that's what I'm doing today. We've got a 22mm quad coil Igo again. So what I'm going to go into first of all is price. Let's get there first of all. $14.99 including the tax on this bad boy for a UD Igo product. Pretty cheap, as vape gear always are. Polished and brass mix, love that. As I said, dual and quad coil setups are available on this one if you choose to utilize them, which is cool also. So what I'm gonna do, guys, I'm gonna quickly tuck this down, show you what's inside, give you a quick look at it. I'm not coiling this on camera. I am just not doing it on camera. So I will show you the coil, and then obviously bring it back up to me and we'll have a nice little vape and a chat about it. Right guys, a little close up of the Igo W6, so I can get straight into it. So first of all, nice little presentation box, W6, UD up there, it's all kind of rainbow. Don't know if you can tell that on the camera. Rebuildable atomizer, flip it over, QR code, which is pretty sweet, relevant C markings, and then some information on the back. Nothing we're going to need to know for this review though. Pop it open, inside we've got a little sleeve, well presented ribbon, pull it out, there we go. And then flip it over in the back, there's like a little secret compartment going on here. And again, more information now. And we have some additional bits and bobs. What have we got here? We've got spare screw for one of the posts. Since it's got five posts, so you just put one on one screw, one, two, three, four O-rings in there, and then there's some strands of eco wool, and then some candle by the look of it, 32 gauge at best, maybe even slightly smaller than that. 28 gauge, 0.32, but I'd imagine, to be honest, it's more 30 gauge. Box done. Now let's get into the Atty quickly. I'll bring a mod involved just to pull her off because Mr. Pete doesn't like hurting his fingers. There we go. And that is her in three parts. That's all it is three parts. So we'll go into top cap first of all. So fairly simple stuff, UD, Igo W6, some kind of, don't know what that is, really sort of 70s style situations going on now with the styling around the body. But it is what it is. In the top, you've actually got a fair chunk of metal in there. Let me just have a little look. So only that much of that in there is actually space. All right at the top is just solid steel. There's a hefty chunk of metal at the top. 510 drip tip goes in there. All the ones I've tried fitted, no problem. It isn't domed or anything like that. It's quite spacious, but it will be to make room for the substantial deck that it's got. That's that. Obviously that slides over here, providing your top cap. This is the bottom section of the cap. Airflow control ring in brass, it is brass as well. You ain't getting it off, to be honest with you, because the O-rings are in the way, but it is what it is. The kind of 70s pattern continues down here, along the bottom of the body. And then inside you've got 1, 2, 3, 4 air holes, obviously quad core guys. And then you've got your adjustable ring that goes over the top so you can lock off or open up as much as you like. You have got two holes there for dual core. These are side by side dual cores, opposed to dual cores on the oppositions. You'd have them like that, 1, 2, 3, 4, fairly simple, and then just knock off one if you wanted to or whatever. But to be honest with you, we're going to go quad, aren't we? So that's just how it is. O-rings up here hold it on. Not had any problems with these O-rings. I've used this a bit and no problems whatsoever. I know earlier versions might have. You've got a chamfer in here along the edge, and then you've got a wider edge there to sit on top of your deck to stop you going down too far. But other than that, it's a fairly simple two-piece top cap. So there we go. Now into the deck, things bloody crazy. You've got central positive post. This is a revised version of the original six. You've got one big nut in here, as opposed to several little ones. So you've got one big nut, twist it off and expose a coiling hole there, which obviously is on the other side. And then at the top you have another one, which is your traditional sort of screw style there, and obviously you can tighten it up. Now looking at the negatives, you've got two taller and then two shorter, so obviously the idea is, you know, I would say vertical coil from here and up into that, and then vertical coil from here and up into that one, which is, I suppose, it's nicer than, for example, the W3 where you had to put all four coils through one positive. There's a very, very slight juice well, it is very fractional though, and then obviously your positive itself. Now the positive itself, I've noticed, is a bit on the piss, it's a bit wonky, as you can probably see that there. It doesn't actually affect the performance of it, but no matter how much I try and how much I bend it back over, it just does seem to make its way back over to the opposite side, so something to bear in mind. Now obviously at the bottom I stand a 510 connection, a non-adjustable connection there, guys. It's just a solid connection, stainless steel connection, I believe, all insulated though, as it should be. And obviously once you chuck your coil in it, you just line up your air holes like so, bosh, and then bosh, and then you're obviously ready to go off and have a vape. Now I am going to coil this, but I ain't doing it on camera, purely because I don't feel like doing it on camera, if I'm honest. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to very quickly chuck a quad in this, and then I will bring you back on the camera just to show you what it looks like, and then, you know, we'll do what we do. So yep, I'm going to go and rebook this now. Alright guys, I've been up, been away, chucking a bit quad in it. So obviously we've gone quad. Now you can see I've gone very excessive with the amount of wick, wick in here. What I've done is gone down, just tucked it under the bottom for down there, as you can see all the way around. Along the top I had the hair sticking out, and what I did was I sliced them down the middle and I've split it one right and one left. Now obviously, as you can see, a monumental amount of cotton in here at the minute, but once we apply some juice, things shall sort themselves out and we can then tuck everything in to where we want it. So that's quickly what I've come back up here to do. Now this is, this is Hodges Homebrew. This is Tropical Storm 100% VG, so good for them clouds. Now obviously being 100% VG, it takes an age to soak into the cotton, so you kind of just sort of leave it there and hope that it finds its way to where it needs to be. To fully prime your setup, just make sure no matter what you do, you always put a generous blob on each coil, so if nothing else, you know if you ignite it, you're gonna be alright for a minute or two. So that's what we've done there. With this amount of cotton, obviously we are gonna have a problem of possibly restricting the airflow, as I said, so need to make sure we flatten this bad boy down at the gaps that we've got. Now obviously you can pack more on to the lower coils because they're lower, so pack more around there, pack more around there. Now my thought process is, it's low res, this is 7 wraps each side of 0.34. I was gonna go with a 0.5, but to be honest with you, I find it just, it takes too long to heat for my liking. I like an instant psh, and not a little psh, fizzle. So we're nearly fully primed, just get it in at the back there. It's not about having a dry back, is it? So get the juice in the back there, and then what I like to do is just make sure that behind each coil, yeah, you got a bit of space. So just tuck your little screwdriver, wherever it is, behind the coil, and make sure you're not smothering your coils with cotton. Now this will be more of an issue on the tops than it would at the bottoms, but it could be an issue down here too. So just make sure you're not smothering your coil and you're giving her room to breathe. Now this is a half dead battery, so I'm not sure what the results of this is going to be, but okay, you've got plenty coming out from all orifices there. So I'm just going to dab a little bit more e-liquid on and then let's bring it up to us for a nice little vape. So just don't forget, guys, get all of your air holes fully open, which is easier said than done when Mr. P rams that top cap on. So get them fully open like that. Well, I mean, if you don't want it fully open, you haven't got to, but get it adjusted to whatever you want. Stick your top cap on, bang in a drip tip, and let's bring this bad boy up for a nice little patinaed vape. Right guys, welcome back up. That was a very quick close-up of the W6. So, yep, there we are. On a nice little heavily patinaed Stingray. But I think the blend works pretty well together, if I'm perfectly honest with you. I'm going to go over a bit of information that's actually listed on the site that I haven't gone over yet. Then we'll get into the review. So, feature is a dripping atomizer. Item number is Nitoco W6. Stainless, material stainless steel and brass. Weight is 54 grams. The height of this bad boy is 36 millimeters, excluding drip tip and connection. And it is a 22 millimeter diameter. The resistance can be adjusted, of course. It's a rebuildable dripping atomizer. You can stick whatever you like in it. It is 510 threaded, as I've just said, so it will fit on any 510 device. It is one of them ones that's come out of, you know, it's been out a while now, but it's just got to me. They did provide this free for review, but as always, it's not going to affect the review. It's just got to me, it's been rehashed, and it's one of them ones that comes out of left field, and it's just a crazy dripping atomizer. Now, I will state this now, I've tried this in Juul, and honestly, it just don't do it for me at all in any way, shape, or form. I don't think it hits the money whatsoever. I don't know whether it's because they're side by side, because of the size of the chamber, or anything else, but that's just not what I'm basing this review on, because it's not what I would do with this device typically, and I don't think it works spectacularly when it is in that configuration. Now, you see in the close-up what I did in here. This is a quad. I mean, quad, this is 0.34 gauge canthal, 0.34 canthal, which is 27 gauge, in fact, 27 gauge is 0.35, so we're 0.1 of a millimetre off of 27 gauge. It's coming in at a resistance of just under 0.2 ohms, so it's low. Make sure you've got relevant batteries, guys. Be aware of that. Does state on the site, let me just have another little. Battery voltage is between 3.7 and 6 volts. I mean, that is entirely true, unless you run it on a VV, in which case you can go anywhere from 3 to 12, depending on what mod you've got. If you've got the BDC like I have, you could get 12 volts for it. I'm just going to have a little vape, because obviously that's what we're going to want to see, and then we'll get into it. This is, as I said down there, if I find the bottle, which I put somewhere, there she is. Tropical Storm 100% VG from Hodges Home Brews. Taste the juice. I do want to say off the bat, the flavour of this is a bit. Surprising. I've had quad call drippers before, I've had many. This is the second from Vape Gear, I've bought many myself, and I've made many dual calls into quad call drippers. The flavour's always been very much pointless because. If you're there to chase clouds. I do want to say, however, in this, the flavour is there. It is definitely there, which is quite surprising. The draw is like breathing in. In fact, it's a very loose draw. Obviously adjustable, but I mean, I'm going to knock it to. I mean, this is nearly closed now. And I'm still getting bad boy flavour, even more so, but it's just, for me, it's too tight. Chasing clouds. I think what I'll do is I'll dive straight into a review. I'm going to do 6-pointers on this, not a 5-pointer, 6-pointer list on this. And then I'll go over any pros and cons along the way. First in the chopping block is looks. She is quite tall, this atomizer, and although it was quite tall, the deck actually starts off somewhere down here, and there's a fair chunk of metal, so the chamber is smaller than you think it's going to be. But that being said, it is a tall atty. For an RDA anyway. But it has to be tall to incorporate that ginormous centre post. Looks-wise, I like the brass, I like the polished stainless steel, I think it looks great on this Stingray. I do not, however, like the 70s style motif that's going around the outside of it. I don't understand why they've done that. You know,
it makes sense to me that that would just not be there and make it polished and literally just have like a W written on it. Some of the newer Igo stuff has gone a bit garish in that way, and I think it's not doing it any favours in my eyes. So for looks and because of them motifs, I'm not going to point off for each of them, so I'm going to give it an 8. But otherwise, I think it's quite a nice looking 8. Very simple and very effective, if you ask me. More options for the flow control ring would be nice. If you can have it in copper, black and stainless steel as well as brass, that would be nice too. But as it is, I don't think she's bad looking. I'm just drawn to them bloody silly things going around the outside of it every time I look at it. So that's what that is. So looks is an 8 from me. Usability is what's next. Now, usability has several factors. So the be all and end all is how easy is it to build. It ain't easy to build. It's not hard for if you're on it. This is not a noob device. If you are getting into this, if you have had a standard Igo W and want to move up to this, don't. Alright, stick with something slightly more friendly and forgiving. This is, if you put a coil in this, it doesn't sit quite right or isn't quite light and quite even, you know, because of the resistances you're running at, it's going to burn or it's not going to taste good, you know. And don't get me wrong, I'm not saying don't buy one if you want to, because, I mean, we don't know until we try it, and how else do you try it but to buy it and try it, you know. But that being said, I wouldn't recommend this for someone who hasn't had a serious amount of time to tinker with your coils and is more than comfortable with your coiling capabilities. That would be, you know, what I would, the first thing I'd pick up on this is usability. Second thing, using it in a dual just really isn't worth it for me. So it is a quad only, you know, for me anyway, although despite the fact it's designed to take dual. If you do that, because they're not opposing coils, they're, you know, opposite, you know, next to each other coils, sorry, you can have one higher than the other. What's the point of that? Just give, I mean, you haven't got to, but the post is designed that way. Unless you go through the same negative, and even then you've got to kind of adapt the positive. So that's not great, and the fact it's four coils is definitely not great for people who aren't experienced, but this is aimed at those who are experienced, you know. It's got to be taken into account though. Now, in this version, you've got the screw at the top and you've got the one nut, which is definitely easier than the other versions. That being said, still not the most easy atomizer to use. It is nice going through and then tightening that screw down, but despite that, still get the pliers on it to tighten it down, give yourself a solid connection, because if you don't, you're not going to get them coils to light nicely, you just won't. And then obviously you've got to stick your other two coils up the top and go through the screw. It's, the nut doesn't make it as user friendly as it could be, but equally there aren't many other ways to do it with the design that they've gone with, you know, and the fact it's quad coil in the first place. Again, usability is getting a 7. If you're an advanced user, you can use this, you can build this no problem, but it'd be a 10 for you. I've built this a few times and every time it's been fine. It's getting them coils to balance, it's seating the coils in a way that might not be natural to you if you're used to going horizontal, going vertically, and vertically is definitely the way forward in this. But usability is a 7. It is not an easy atomizer to use. It's a severely advanced piece of equipment. This is not just, you know, advanced, you know, because of RDA or whatever. Some places would consider a Nautilus advanced. It's not in comparison. This is another level. Even if you use your Zenith, it's another level. And just be aware of that. So usability, I'm going to give a 7.2. Maintenance. Now, you've got to take care of your coils, you've got to keep them clean, keep them wicked, keep them topped up with juice. Once you've got the coils in there, maintaining this device, with the exception of the fact it is a bit of a fingerprint magnet, it's fairly easy stuff. So I'm going to give it a 10 for that. Let me just check the juice level. I've had a few puffs on this. I will say, the quad core builds that I do when I do them, always seem to dry them cotton out perfectly. It's not like jewels, which start to get a little bit of a dry hit before it's drier. They tend to just dry it out. Let me just make sure I've got plenty of juice on these guys, because if you don't, it's going to be an unpleasant experience. Now, next would be build quality and price. Price is 15 quid, and for that, you're getting the option to do dual coil. Not that I'd recommend it, but you are getting the option. You've got a quad coil dripper. It looks pretty cool. Not a big fan of them things, but it looks pretty cool. And it's something that, if you are at that level where you've got your orbital dripping atomizers and you're doing dual coils, and you're the next step. This is the next step. If you're, this is a cloud chaser's dripper. That's what it's made for. It's not made to give you the best flavour. Despite that, it does give you a great flavour. But you've got to make sure it works at that flavour. This juice I find tastes best around half an ohm. Now, 0.5 ohms. With this, this is sort of 0.18, and I'm getting an equivalent flavour. But the problem with that is, though, is it says to me that if I was to put a 0.5 ohm in this, which is, pardon me, 4 2 ohm coils, I'm not going to get the good flavour. I'm going to have to bring it lower. Now, that has repercussions. Big ones, in fact. Juice consumption goes through the roof. I've only used this juice on this dripper twice. I don't know if you can make that out. It's half empty, okay? And I haven't used it for extended periods of times. 45 minutes, you're changing battery at this resistance anyway, because you're raping your batteries. Honestly, you can barely charge them quick enough to use this. They're the main two, to be honest with you, with exception of the build. They are the main two, but they're important ones. If you're using, I mean, if you're using a Cloud Chaser juice that you're purchasing and you're paying between sort of £8 and £18 a bottle, doing an 18 quid bottle of juice in 2-3 days is definitely not advisable for your bank balance. I'm not saying, you know, if you can afford it, go for it, but it still doesn't make sense to me. And your batteries, again, you're having to carry extra batteries, or you're having to constantly charge batteries. In a by association, you're reducing the life of them batteries, not on a day-to-day basis, but in a general lifespan basis. Charging them 3 times a day, you're getting 33% of the potential life out of them batteries, because let's face it, 2,500 mile 35 amp EFES should be lasting most of us a day, there or thereabouts, depending on what device you're using. Some of us use 2, but whatever you're going to use, expect to double it, basically, in this, so you know you're getting a third to half of the life from your batteries that you could potentially could have, and therefore it's costing you more money. It's just something to bear in mind. I've deviated a bit. The point was build quality. The build quality is a 10. The price, it is a 10. It's 15 quid, you know, and you're getting a lot of atomizer for your 15 quid. And it's going to save you drilling and customizing to get them silly quad coils when it's made to take them. I mean, 4 posts, 1 positive, 2 separate holes. You could get 8 coils in this if you really, really wanted to. Just relevant resistances, guys, and be careful. Always use safe batteries. But build quality versus price, it's a 10 all day long. No problem whatsoever. Next, flavour and vapour. So, the vapour is a 10 plus a million times 10 billion. The vapour is a great vapour. Off of a stockade that hasn't been drilled, using a resistance that is within the realms of safety. I'd like to point out as well, if I was standing up, I could take twice as long a draw, there'd be a lot more vapour. But even still, it's an immense vapour, and it's getting a massively high mark, as high as I can possibly give it, 10 plus, you know, it's, you can see it, in fact you can still see it, and it's going to be a while before it goes anywhere. So the vapour is a massive 10. The flavour of this I'm quite impressed with. For what it is, it provides a good flavour, but still does what it's designed to do, which is throw massive buckets full of cloudy goodness. So I'm going to give the flavour a 10, I'm actually quite impressed by it. So yeah, 10 and 10 for those two. Now overall, if you're not a cloud chaser, don't bother. If you are not wanting to charge batteries very often, same result. If you're not wanting to waste loads of e-liquid, same again. But if you like to go a bit crazy, if you want something that's made to do it to save you having to customise an atty, if you want something that's good on flavour when it does, you know, chuck them clouds, if you like the way it looks, then all these things that are positives, it's a great price, it's a great starting atty for this kind of craziness. There are others out there, don't get me wrong, but it is a great, I've got a Mutation X. This thing chucks it just as well as that does, to be honest with you, and this does it with a nice warmer vape. Right, this isn't a hot vape by any stretch of imagination. This isn't getting hot, it's warm, it's not hot. Customise that is get hot. The Mutation X isn't a customised atty, but it is ice cold, that vapour. And to get the best from that atty, you've got to go stupid, silly, sub-ohm 0.06 and stuff like that. And even still, is limited by your lungs, and this will do the job just as well. Alright, so I think for 15 quid, bit of a bargain, I'm perfectly honest with you, it feels great, the build's great. The wonky centre post is a pain in my hole. Not that it's affecting the performance in any way, shape or form, because it isn't. But it is a bugbear of mine. Give me a straight centre post, UD. It's a great 80. It really is. It's a great performer. I am not going to use this every day, and I ain't going to lie that I would every either. I'm definitely not going to use this every day. There's no way in hell I would. But when I want to chase some clouds, and I think on this Stingray in particular, if I polish it up a little bit and get rid of that 6 months worth of patina that's been sitting in the drawer, I broke out specifically for this, and I think it's a great looking setup. So I'll definitely recommend it, guys. For 15 quid, it's well worth a go. I'm pretty much done for the review. I just want to say a big thank you to Keith and Kirsty for sending this down to me. I'm very grateful for that. And obviously a big thank you to you guys for watching. If you did want to go ahead and check out Vape Gear, it will be down here linked for you, and it will be up here somewhere as well. Other than that, guys, thank you very much for watching. I've been Mr. P. Shall see you soon.